Hello, let's take a look at local and remote pluggable database clones on the Exadata Database Exascale service. From the OCI main menu, I'll select Oracle Database and then select the Oracle Exadata Database on Exascale service. I will select the region I'm working in, and here I can see my Exascale clusters. I will select one of the clusters, scroll down, and this will show me the container databases being hosted by this cluster. If I select one, in this case RWDB1, I can scroll down and select the pluggable databases link to show the pluggable databases being hosted by this container database. If we select one of the pluggable databases, this brings me to the pluggable database page. And from here, I have different things I can do, but one of the options is the clone button. From here, I can create a local clone, which is a local copy of a pluggable database within the same container database. Or I can create a remote clone. So this is taking a local pluggable database and cloning that onto a remote container database, either within the same cluster or a separate cluster. Or refreshable clones, which we'll look at in a separate video. So today we're going to look at local clones and refreshable clones. If we select local clone, then the VM cluster and the container database is grayed out because it has to be local. It's a local clone, so they're already selected for us. I will configure the name. I'll create a name for my local clone. I'll call it PDB local. And I need to provide the database's TDE wallet password. I can decide whether I want to unlock the new PDB's admin account or not. For this example, I will unlock it. So I select the tick box, and then I need to provide a admin password and then verify the admin password I have chosen, ensuring that it meets the recommended password criteria. I can decide to take a backup immediately after the clone has been created. I won't do that in this case. If I deselect, it will warn me that the clone PDB will not be recoverable until either an auto backup has taken place or I take a manual backup. I can also enable thin clone technology. So by default, this is off, and this means we'll get a full copy, a full clone of the source PDB. If I enable the thin clone, then the clone will share the blocks with the parent PDB, and there'll be a copy on write of blocks that are changed by the clone. So this is a space efficient way of doing things, so I will select this. If I now clone the pluggable database, we're taken to the pluggable database clone, which we called PDB local. We can see the work request. We can see it's been accepted and that it's currently 0% complete. I will speed this part of the video up for time's sake. If we look at the container database during the provisioning of the pluggable clone, we can see the container database is in an updating state as well. And if we go down to the pluggable databases link, we can see that both the provisioning thin clone PDB local is in a provisioning state, and the source pluggable database, which we're cloning from, RWPDB2, is in an updating state. Now the local clone is being created, the work request shows as succeeded. If we select the container database, we can see that's moved back to a status of available. And if we select the pluggable databases, we can see the PDB local clone, thin clone is marked as available, as is the source PDB, RWPDB2. Note that the open mode for the local clone is marked read-write. If we move back to the container database and we select a pluggable database, RWPDB4 in this case, we can select the clone button, and this time we'll take a look at remote clone. With a remote clone, we can clone a pluggable database to a different container database. This can be in a different VM cluster, but the container database must be in the same availability domain. And if you're using different VCNs for the different container databases, those VCNs must be peered before cloning starts. I will select my same cluster for this example, and I will select a different container database for the target. This database is in the same availability domain and is showing the same VCN as the source. I'll provide a PDB name for the remote clone. I'll call it PDB remote. And I have to provide the database TD wallet password. Again, I can decide whether I want to unlock the PDB admin account or not. I will. I select the checkbox, and then I have to provide a password for the admin account that meets the password criteria. A database link will be used to copy the data between the container databases. I need to provide the source database sys password, and then I get the option to use or specify the database user for the link. And if I specify a user, I would need to specify the database user's password as well. So this is optional. We don't have to do this. And if we don't do this, a database link will be created for us. Now, when we come to refreshable clones, which is in a separate video, this would be a mandatory step. So we can, as this is optional, we can leave it blank. I then have the option of whether I would like to take a backup of the PDB, the remote PDB, after creation. I won't, so I'll deselect that. And by deselecting it, it will warn me that until an auto backup has occurred or a manual backup has occurred, the new PDB will not be recoverable. I can look at the advanced options, and this is just where I can add some tags should I want to. And then when I'm ready, I can click clone pluggable database. Depending on the size of the pluggable database will depend on how long it will take to clone across the database link. It takes us to the remote clone that's being built. We can see it's being provisioned. We can see the work request underneath. And if we slip back to the container database, we can see it's now moved us to the target database. So this is the container database that's basically having the remote clone copied to. It's in an updating state. If we go to pluggable databases for that target database, we can see that the PDB remote, the remote clone, is being provisioned while the rest are available. If I go back one step to the VM cluster details and scroll down, I can see both the target DB and the source DB, which in this case is RWDB1, are both in an updating state. I select the source container database. You see it's in an updating state. And if I look at its pluggable databases, we can see the source pluggable database, in this case RWPDB4, is in an updating state, while the other pluggable databases are available. I speeded up the provisioning for the video for the sake of time. We can now see that the remote clone has been successfully created. It's opened in read-write mode. And if we go to the container database details and select pluggable databases, we can see again in the list it's marked as available. This ends the video. I hope it's been useful to you. Thanks for watching.